Okay, so this is a quick module where I want to show you how using the improved Euler method in place of the Euler method can actually dramatically improve the quality of the results, right? So the quick recap is about how we looked at the driven oscillator. You know, we went through all these analysis, non-dimensionalization, etc. We wrote down the steady state solution, then we worked out the transient solution, which comes out from finding the general solution of the homogeneous equation. Then we stitch them together, write down the full solution, which includes inputs from the initial conditions as well, right? Then we visualized the data, we visualized the solution, then we argued about the subtleties associated with the resonance point omega equal to 1, and we saw how the solution is of a different kind there. And then we basically reproduced the data using the Euler method. So let's so I have to do this clear global so that there is no memory of the system, so that I don't need this. I will go on to Euler improve. Okay, so the improved Euler method is like the Euler method, but it just introduces one in between step. So in the Euler method, what do? You just go from xn to xn plus 1. Here too, that's what you will eventually do. But you don't directly go from xn to xn plus 1. You go to an xn plus 1, which is like the Euler method, right? So xn plus h times. So you try to go to the next step, but then you try, you use the information about of the derivatives at both the points, right? So there is a certain, so you, in the Euler method, you go to xn plus 1 using the derivative information at xn, and that's it. You have moved to the next step. But here what you do is you pretend to go to xn plus 1, but you call it only x tilde n plus 1, and then go there and figure out the derivative information there, and then use the derivative information at this tilde point, and then along with the derivative information at xn itself, and take the average of these two. That's the third step. And it turns out that this method of finding the derivative is going to give you much better results. So technically, this becomes a, it reduces the local error from h cubed to order h squared, right? So the details you don't have to understand at this point. So there is the notion of local error, global error, and all this, which you might see in a more sophisticated numerical methods course. But so we are here interested only in the implementation of this, and you can directly see by comparing with your numerics of using this method and the other method that this is better. Okay, so this can also be written as in this more compact way. And the Euler, improved Euler method is also known as the second order RK method, Runge-Kutta method. So there is a more powerful fourth order Runge-Kutta method, which also we will discuss at some point, or maybe we'll give it to you as a homework. So if you want, you can pause and take the code from last time, right, where the Euler method is implemented, and make some small modifications to it, and then you can get the code for the improved Euler method, right? And then go ahead and use the improved Euler methods to solve the driven harmonic oscillator problem. We have already seen how to solve the driven harmonic oscillator with the Euler method, and then you can compare the accuracy of these two doing some tests. So that's what I'm doing here. So this is my implementation of improved Euler method, right? So only some small modifications to it. There is this in between step which comes in, right, which is also implemented in here. But once again, I urge you to find your own solution before you look at my solution. Maybe you have a better solution, who knows, right? So we'll clear omega. Then once again, I have, you know, these three functions remain unchanged, right? And then I input all this, I choose omega equal to 1. So now you see that if I use Euler gen, what was taking me so long? Okay, so since I want to compare against Euler gen, I have copied the old code as well for comparison here, and I have copied and pasted it. I will run it, and then if I go ahead and run this, so this should work out all right. So there you go. This is data that we have already seen. This is a plot that you have already seen. But now I want to redo the whole calculation, but with the improved Euler method. There you go. So you see that the agreement is much better. Not only is the agreement much better, but look at the time steps involved. I only run it for 2000. There I ran with, even though I ran it with 10,000, the agreement was not so great. So here it's like practically indistinguishable. The red and the black are sitting on top of each other if I run it for 10,000, which I don't even need to do. 2000 already is good enough. If I go to the resonant case, let's see what happens with the resonant case. This is the old one. So we saw that for larger times, it failed more by a bigger and bigger margin. With improved Euler method, once again, even just with keeping this as 1000, this parameter as 1000, already the agreement is excellent. So when you go from just the Euler method by a small modification to improved Euler method, already you see that the results have improved so dramatically. But if you go from RK2 to RK4, the results will be even more dependable. And so in fact, RK4 is the standard method which is very reliable. Even there are higher order methods, but there's always a cost. You know, you pay in terms of the complexity of the code, but for the accuracy that you get. But it turns out that a nice balance between cost of the algorithm and accuracy is found in the RK4 method, which will be described later on. Okay, so that's what this module was about. But I want to finish this with some fun and games. So it turns out that you can actually literally play sounds on Mathematica. So there was this previous lecture where I talked about oscillations and how you can superpose oscillations, you know, in terms of the linear superposition principle and so on. So it turns out that you can go to Mathematica and create a wave like this, and not only visualize it, but actually you can hear it, right? So you create a wave of this kind, a cosine of omega 1t. I've chosen a bunch of frequencies, and you'll see in a moment why I have chosen these. And there is this command called play. You can go ahead and play these various frequencies, right? So I have chosen a set of frequencies very carefully. You'll see in a moment what they imply. So if I play this, there you go, right? So I hope you recognize what that was. In fact, you can go ahead and create your own small groups of notes, and then you can superpose various waves and play them together and see if you can make some nice discoveries or some happy sounds can come out of this. Okay, so that's what this module was about. Thank you.